Back in the dark days of the early 1940s, the skies over Britain droned with the sound of aircraft in combat. So vital was the part that the Royal Air Force played in the Battle of Britain that it inspired the then Prime Minister Winston Churchill to make his famous speech. Never in the field of human conflict was so much owed by so many to so few. That proud tradition remains strong to the present day, for the Royal Air Force is second to none. Since September 1982, the School of Recruit Training has been located on the open, windswept Lincolnshire countryside at RAF Swinderby. And it's to here that the many young men and women come to undertake a six-week intensive training course to become members of the Royal Air Force. As they step down from the coach, those first few steps must seem rather daunting. A visit to the barber's is high on the agenda, which can be a shock to the system. The transformation from a civilian to a military personnel can be bewildering, but soon a sense of comradeship is formed. It's back to the classroom, for the RAF is at the forefront of technology. Initially, it's basic awareness of military life. Then it's time to encounter your friendly drill instructor. Here are a few scenes that may bring back some vivid memories. We'll be right back. the successful recruits, their stay at Swinderby culminates in the ceremonial passing out parade, when families and friends are invited to the station to experience a day to remember.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of the station commander, Group Captain Williams, can I wish you a very warm welcome to Royal Air Force Swinderby. Here we have typical Lincolnshire weather, but fortunately it's not raining, which means that we're able to be outdoors, but I hope that you've all got access to some sort of rug to keep you warm. There's no underfloor heating, I'm afraid. If I can just introduce myself, I'm Squadron Leader Lister, and I'm the officer commanding number 3 squadron, which is the squadron that the recruits of numbers 16, 17, 18 and 19 flights today are on parade. I'd like to take this opportunity to mention a few details about today's parade. The reviewing officer is Group Captain Burridge, who is the station commander of Royal Air Force Kinloss. We are hopeful of a fly pass today, but with the cloud base being what it is possible that you won't see an aircraft, you'll just sort of hear a noise. But let me tell you, that noise is a Nimrod aircraft from Group Captain Burridge's station, Royal Air Force Kinloss. The musical support for today's ceremonial is provided by the band of the Royal Air Force College, Cranwell. During the parade, there are going to be 4 occasions when we would ask you to stand. First, when the reviewing officer arrives to take the salute. Second, when the parade advances in review order and a second general salute is given. Third, when the padre says prayers. And fourth, when the reviewing officer leaves the parade. Don't worry, you will be told when to stand. If in doubt, take your cue from the people in the comfy chairs in the front row. Well, today's parade, as I'm sure you'll realise, is the culmination of 6 weeks' hard work on the part of both the recruits and their flight staff. So please feel free to applaud the march on. These young men and women, they always grow about 6 inches if they know that mum and dad is in the audience and is clapping them. That is if you recognise your son and daughter. We're very good at cloning, and it might take you the whole of the parade to actually figure out which one belongs to you. Anyway, please do applaud the march on, and then when the ceremonial is complete, the presentation of the trophies and the march off. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I'd just like to tell you a little bit about the charity work that these young men and women have done. They do work very hard, and I'm sure that they have told you or regaled you with stories of what they've done and how little sleep they've got and the long hours. There's a little bit of poetic license, but they do work jolly hard. But despite that, they managed to find time to undertake work for charity, and I'm just about to say what they have done. The whole intake organised a truck pull around the airfield, which was quite an occasion, and they decided that they would donate money to charities of their choices. And number 16 flight, they raised £400, and that money they have decided is going part to cancer research and part to improve their own Barrett Block charity beginning at home. Number 17 flight, they raised just under £400, and they decided that their money would go to the local school at Swinderby. As did 19 flight, they raised £350, and their money is also going to the Swinderby local village school. Number 18 flight, they raised over £300, and their money, they have decided, is going to cystic fibrosis. So the intake, the 4 flights together, have raised about £1,500, which is a tremendous effort from them. When the parade is over, buses will come to take you to the Newcomers Club, where you will be reunited with your son's daughters and friends. A video is being taken and photographs will also be available for you to see in the Newcomers Club after the parade. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope your visit to Swinderby will be an enjoyable one. I personally would like to thank you all for making the journey here today. I know that some of you have come great distances. I'd like to thank you for your support today and also for your support of these young men and women in the past 6 weeks as they embark upon what is a new career for them, and I'm sure for the support that you're going to give them when they leave here today and they proceed onto their trade training. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope you enjoy today's parade. It's going to be a good one, I know. It's a splendid occasion for the young men and women on parade and for their flight staff who have guided and instructed them, and I hope that you will enjoy it also. Thank you.
Thank you. Have you seen one of them?
Pardon?
Have you seen one of them?
One of these?
One of the big ones.
No, this is the slim.
They're very big, yeah. Got the entrance, the fire car and stuff.
Yeah.
You know, big things.
I wanted to see...
Thank you. Number one flight. Stand up. East.
Thank you. Thank you. Numbers 1 and 2, fire the left. Quick! Hold!
Thank you.
advance and review order. Fire the centre! Quick! Bolt! General salute! Present! Up! Shoulder! Up! Order! Up! Ceremonial is now complete. The parade is ready for the presentation of trophies and awards. Stop!
During their training, the recruits compete for individual trophies and awards. The Hake Trophy is awarded to the recruit who achieves the highest overall standard in ground defence training. This trophy has been won by Air Crew Cadet Utting of No. 17 Flight, who will train as an air electronics operator. The North Kesteven Trophy is awarded to the recruit who has displayed the highest overall standard of effort, determination, and achievement in physical education. This trophy has been won by Air Crew Cadet Stinton of No. 16 Flight, who will train as an air engineer. Certificates of merit are awarded to the best all-round recruit on each flight. In addition, the best WRF recruit receives the Lincoln Trophy, and the best overall RAF recruit receives the National Westminster Shield. On number 18 flight, the best all-round recruit is aircraftman Mason, who will train as an aircraft technician electrical. On number 19 flight, the best all-round recruit is Air Crew Cadet King, who will train as an air electronics operator. The Lincoln Trophy for the best WRAF recruit of the intake has been awarded to senior aircraft woman Higgins of number 17 flight, who will train as a staff nurse. The National Westminster Shield for the best RAF recruit of the intake has been awarded to aircrew cadet Stinton of number 16 flight, who will train as an air engineer. Finally, the flights compete for the Halifax Trophy, which is awarded for the best overall performance in drill, physical education, and general service training. This trophy has been awarded to number 17 flight and will be collected on behalf of the flight by aircraft woman Kirk.
Lord God, we acknowledge that you are the source of life. Without you, we and all things would cease to be. So we stand together to give thanks for all your goodness to us. Help us to return to you in heart, mind, and body the trust you place in us, as the highest of your creation, with responsibilities to fashion your world. Lord God, we ask that you would uphold all who serve in the Royal Air Force. And today we especially remember, on this day of achievement, number 3 Squadron, and flights 16, 17, 18, and 19. And we pray that you would help us at all times. Give us clear sight that we may know what to do. Courage to embark upon the tasks you show us are right. Skill to find a way through the problems facing us. Perseverance to finish the tasks begun. And strength to keep the vows we have made today. O Lord our God, we ask that you would keep in your concern all those who have the responsibility of leadership throughout the nations at this time. Give courage to those who seek to establish peace with justice, and shelter all those who wait to serve mankind in the shadow of war. And may that peace, which God alone can give to us, keep us in his knowledge and aware of his blessing upon us, now and always. Amen. And as we stand together, let parents, friends, and relatives supporting our graduating recruits today say the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Graduating recruits of Number 3 Squadron, first of all, I must compliment you on the standard of your turnout and congratulate you on the standard of your drill on this very cold parade square this morning. I suspect that most of you will recognize that only 6 short weeks ago, you were nothing more than a group of individuals. But now, with the skill of your instructors, you've been formed into a team. And the achievements of today on this parade square indicate just how much can be achieved through teamwork. Of course, there are others here who will recognize better than I the changes that have taken place in you. And here, of course, I refer to the many relatives and friends who've come to witness this special day. And I would bid them a very warm welcome, especially that by chance we've chosen such an inclement day. But especially warm welcome to those who I know have traveled large distances to be here. I hope that you and your relatives and friends will take away special memories of this day, for it is a first and very important milestone in your careers. So what does the future hold for you in your careers and for the Royal Air Force in particular? We've seen some momentous changes of late. The political situation in Europe has changed beyond recognition. These changes, I might add, have come about because of the success of the NATO alliance in preserving peace for more than 40 years since the Second World War. But regrettably, we need look no further than the crisis in the Gulf to see what might beset us around every corner. And here, the role of air forces in general and air power in particular is preeminent. Air power, with its characteristics of reach, speed of reaction, and flexibility of employment, is a vital ingredient for the future, whether it be in protecting the UK's worldwide interests, or indeed protecting the values of the free world. And the Nimrod that you heard earlier, if indeed you didn't see it, is an indication of what this all means, because the crew flying that aircraft have just themselves returned from duty in the Gulf. As soon as the crisis broke out, aircraft and crews from my station at Kinloss deployed to the Gulf, as part of the multinational effort aimed at preserving the peace. And of course, this multinational effort is a team game. And just as that's a team game, so it is for each individual Royal Air Force unit serving in the Gulf. Of course, aircraft need crews to fly them. And to get over a parade like this today, in this sort of weather, will have taken teamwork of the highest order from my crew. But there's more to flying and operating aircraft than just aircrew. They need ground crew engineers to support them, and a plethora of other trades acting in support. And here I would include communicators, security, administrative staff, catering staff, and medical staff, amongst others. And all these people have an important part to play in forming this team, which becomes the major tool in reaching our objective, whatever that may be. So before very long, you will all embark on your professional training. And you'll find soon after that that you're given responsibility and that you too will be a vital part of this team. At this stage, that presents a major challenge to you. But for the moment, or today at least, you can reflect on the success that you've achieved on this course. Do remember, though, that your own efforts will decide the success that you make of your careers. You can approach the future with confidence because you've all proved that you have the basic building blocks of success. The challenge now is to build on your strengths and eradicate your weaknesses. And we all have weaknesses. In this, I wish you the best of good fortune and congratulate you on your success to date. Well done to you all.
Thank you. 6 weeks or so ago, you all arrived at Royal Air Force Swinderby from every corner of the country and from many different backgrounds and experiences. Over the past 6 weeks, you and my staff have worked hard to change you from civilians into basic military people. You have learnt the basic military skills, and you have learnt the value of teamwork and team spirit. As you now move on into the broader Royal Air Force to learn your trade skills and help defend this country, take the value of that basic training with you. You are about to join a service with a proud tradition and a hard-fought-for reputation. In the political climate of 1990, peace now seems more assured, but new challenges will arise, and we and you as part of the Royal Air Force must be ready to meet them. Finally, let me wish you and your families every luck in the future, and to each of you, successful and happy careers in the Royal Air Force.